Josesito Lopez Chia Santana, your prediction?
I want to call it an early night.
Josesito, what do you think? He said an early night.
It always ends early, but I prepare to go 12 rounds. I'm physically, mentally ready.
It's not your first camp.
No, definitely not my first. I'm ready for anything.
And what do you think about the main event? Spence, I watched it. Did you watch him train last week by any chance?
Spence? No, I didn't.
He looked good. Did you see him?
No.
He looked ripped. He looked yoked out. He looked healthy. He looked ready to fight.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure, man. Especially when, give your life flash before your eyes, you get that second opportunity, not only in life, but at boxing, I'm glad that he's still able to fight.
So who do you have in the main event?
The main event, I have the fans winning.
Man. The fans are the winners. That's my slogan.
Yeah. No, I think it's a good fight. I mean, it's a lot closer fight than people think. And, a lot of people are curious to see how Spence reacts, after a horrible accident. So we'll see. We won't know. I don't think he even knows technically.
I spoke to Virgil. Virgil Ortiz grew up with Errol. He knows him very well. They started out at the same gym, right? And Virgil told me that he has Errol winning, but he says that Danny Garcia is the hardest hitting fighter at 147. Do you agree?
Quite possibly. He's a strong fighter.
You hit very hard. Virgil hits hard. Spence hits hard. Mikey hits hard. Yeah. A lot of people.
I mean, it's hard to say that he's the heaviest handed or the hardest puncher.
But he could be.
I've sparred Danny Garcia a lot of years back, and he is strong. He's strong, man, and he's gotten better since I sparred him. It's not a walk in the park for Errol.
How hard does Danny hit? Or he didn't hit you?
No, it's sparring, so he definitely hit me. I think he's gotten stronger since then.
Because he was 135, 140. Now he's 147. What did you think of Kell Brook and Crawford?
I think it was exciting early, especially seeing Brook get off a little bit, Crawford made the right adjustments and really punished him, made it out, made it early.
Josesito, if you win your fight, you're obviously going to be ringside for the main event. Do we see you after the main event run in the ring, grab a microphone, and call out the winner?
Maybe.
You're going to do it, slide in, and say, they've been doing that. Sean Porter did that, right? With Danny Garcia. I remember Sean Porter came in the ring with Danny. Who else did that? We've seen that happen a few times.
Yeah, it's happened a couple of times. I think Errol did that, or Danny. Or after one of Danny's fight, I think that happened.
Yeah.
I mean, if I were to do that, it'd be respectfully,
I would like to kick your ass respectfully, sir.
Yeah, I just want to fight. I want to fight the best fighters in the world. So, it doesn't matter how it happens, as long as I would sell myself to do something that I wouldn't necessarily do.
Right, but you're open to fight anybody at 47. Right. It doesn't matter. Any name.
Yep.
Line them up. You and Crawford, you're welcoming that fight.
Best fighters, all the fighters. Want to fight the best.
So let me ask both of you guys, Crawford Spence, who wins if they fight?
Start with him.
The fans.
The fans, he said the fans are the winners.
Same here.
Should it be 60-40, 50-50, 40-40, winner takes 20, winner takes all, winner gets a bonus?
Damn. Probably winner takes the extra 20, 40-40.
Would you like that if you fought someone and they said the winner takes the extra 20? Or would you be like, nah, pay me my cut?
No, I've never been in a situation like that, so it's different. Plus, I don't know. I don't know how I would prefer, but that's one of the best fights there is out there, in the welterweight division.
I definitely want to see it.
Yeah, I think everyone does. Every boxing fan does. That's the matchup. Hopefully, it doesn't take too long if it ever happens. But first things first, Spence got a big big task with Garcia in a couple weeks, so we'll see how that goes.